Welcome to the first of several videos on integration involving inverse trigonometric functions. Let's go ahead and take a look at our integration rules. In order to apply these properly, I think pattern recognition is probably the most important skill to have. Notice there's only one that does not have a square root in the denominator. So if we don't have a square root, we're going to be dealing with arctangent. And then if it does have a square root, notice that one of them has, notice the formula for arc sine is a squared minus u squared, and the formula for arc secant is u squared minus a squared, and this formula also has u outside the square root. Now you might be asking, where are the formulas involving arc cosine, arc cotangent, and arc cosecant? Remember when we were doing derivatives, this first column and the second column were just opposites of one another. So it's pretty standard for textbooks when integrating, we use these three inverse trig functions rather than these three. Because if we did integrate this with respects to u, instead of saying arc cosine u, we could say negative arc sine u. Let's go and take a look at our examples. Again, the first thing we want to do is be able to recognize which formula we are going to apply. And the key is the denominator. We have the square root of 16 minus x squared. So if we look at these three formulas, that pattern fits the first one. So let's go ahead and rewrite this and see if we can make it fit this pattern. Let's first factor the 2 out. So we'd have dx in the numerator. And for our denominator, we want the square root of a squared minus u squared. So we could rewrite 16 as 4 squared, and u squared would be x squared. So what this tells us is that u is equal to x, and a is equal to 4. Now the next thing we should recognize is that all of these formulas are in terms of u. So it's important that we find differential u to make sure we do not have to perform a substitution. In this case, du would be equal to 1 dx, or just dx, so no substitution is required. So now we can apply the formula. So the antiderivative would be 2 times arc sine u over a. Well, u is x, and a is 4, plus c. So this one was pretty straightforward. Let's go and take a look at another one. Again, step one is to identify the correct formula. Notice our denominator does not have a square root, so we're looking at the second formula now. So our antiderivative should involve arctangent. Let's go ahead and see if we can identify the values of a and u by making this fit the pattern. So our denominator needs to be a squared plus u squared. Well, if we let a squared equals 5, that means a would be the square root of 5. So we can rewrite this as the square root of 5 squared plus, for u squared, if u squared is equal to 16x squared, u would be 4x. So if we square 4x, we will get 16x squared. So this tells us that a is equal to the square root of 5, and u is equal to 4x. Again, this formula is in terms of u, so it's important that we determine du. Well, du would equal 4 dx. Since our current integrand has just dx, let's go ahead and divide both sides by 4. So we have 1/4 du is equal to dx. Let's go ahead and rewrite this in terms of u using a, u, and 1/4 u equals dx. Okay, so dx is equal to 1/4 du. The square root of 5 is equal to a, so we would have a squared plus, and u is equal to 4x, so we do have u squared. So this fits the pattern that we need to apply the formula. So we're going to have 1/4 times this antiderivative, which would be 1 over a, so 1 over the square root of 5, times arctangent of u over a plus c. Again, u is 4x, and a is square root of 5. And of course, we can rewrite this first fraction as 1 over 4 square root of 5, Let's go ahead and do that. Let's go and take a look at one more. Again, what should stand out for this one is that it has a square root, and we also have x outside the square root. So for this integral, we'll apply the third formula. Now that we've identified our formula, let's go ahead and see if we can make it fit the pattern to identify a and u. So notice that u squared must equal 9x squared, so that means u would be 3x. And then a squared must equal 4, so this would be minus 2 squared. Now we do have a little bit of a problem here. We can see that a is going to equal 2, and u has to be equal to 3x. But notice that we have to have a u outside the square root as well, and we don't, we only have x. Since we do have to have a 3 here, we can multiply the top and bottom by 3, so this would be 3x, as long as we have 3dx in the numerator. Now notice that it does fit the pattern. There's u squared, and there's a squared. Next, we need to identify du. Well, du would equal 3dx. And if we look at our integrand, we do have a 3dx, so all of this will be equal to du. Let's go ahead and take this and rewrite it in terms of u and a to make sure it fits the pattern. So 3dx is equal to du, 3x is equal to u, so this would be u squared, and a is equal to 2, so this would be minus a squared. Again, it's a perfect match, so now we can find the antiderivative. It'll be equal to 1 over a, or 1 half, times arc secant of the absolute value of u over a, absolute value of 3x over 2, and then plus c. Okay, this is the first of several videos on integrals involving inverse trigonometric functions, so I do recommend you watch part 2.